absolutely flying up this hill, flipping amazing. I hope you can hear me. The UK's been hit with some terrible weather in the last week or so. Anyway, I've been given another bike to show on the channel. This is the Cyrusher Ranger. As you can see, mine is in rather a muddy condition. This bike is available in three colours, I believe: green, black and white. Anyway, stay tuned and I'll give you my impressions of it. Yeah, I know. I got those silly goggles on again, but they do help my eyes. So I got to wear them, especially in this cold, windy weather. But I did come out today to try the Cyrusher Ranger up a steep local hill known as Jacob's Ladder. The bike covered in filth, as you can see. But really enjoying it. I've just had a nice ride around the local area, taken on board some very gravelly, rough paths that were passable. They were dry, not so muddy. And the one thing that I can say, being a full suspension bike, is how well it actually absorbs all the bumps. Obviously, those big tyres, the 26x4-inch tyres, also help in that. But it rides over the bumps like you wouldn't believe. You could never go as quick as that on a conventional bicycle. Just got to say that this little aftermarket mudguard is something that I've put on. The saddle's very comfortable. It's got an interesting cutout in there, which again just alleviates pressure points, I suppose. And it's plastered in muck. So I do apologise to Cyrusher for the state of the bike, but they did say to me, take it out and use it. So that's exactly what I've done. I'll give you some specifications on the bike. I've got a bit of a cheat sheet so I don't forget. The motor, it's a 750 watt Befang. Apparently these are almost indestructible motors. They're very well thought of and highly regarded, I believe, and used a lot in e-bikes. 750 watt. And it's peak 1200 watts at 80 newton meters, but of course it's limited for the UK to an output of 250 watts. I don't think they limit the actual torque figures though, because there's plenty of power and torque to it. But it will get it up to about 15.5-16 mile an hour, and then you can feel the cutoff coming in. There is a way to override that, but you've got to go into the electronics of the bike and remove a wire. But then of course you would be making the bike illegal for use on the road, so that's something that you do at your own risk. Tyres, a Kenda Crusade 26x4, very good imposing looking tyres. It's got a 20 amp hour battery. The battery is accessed, you've got a key slot on the other side and a toggle there, and the whole battery drops out. It's a massive battery, it takes about 6 hours to charge it. The range on the Ranger is between 35 and 55 miles. Currently, I'm on 37.7 miles, and I've still got about 65% of battery remaining. And what I've been tending to do is ride to the place where I want to have my fun, so to speak. So say if I want to ride out to where I know there's a good hill climb, I'll ride from my home there on power assistance number one, and then when I get there I've used hardly any battery, and then I can use the higher assist modes for exploring that area and having a bit of fun. It is primarily a fun bike, I'd say. It's got a 9-speed Shimano drivetrain and derailleur with a nice range of ratios. But believe me, this bike is not a bike you're going to be pedaling much. It's a bike where you really need the motor, because if you had to pedal it, unless it was going downhill or on a flat with the wind behind you, it's a struggle. It relies on the motor. This is an interesting thing, because the whole back triangle, it's all got on a suspension system, and you've got an air shock here. The air shock is adjustable. You can increase the pressure by using a special shock pump to boost the pressure. It's adjustable for preload and rebound, and you can also lock it out with this blue toggle here. The front forks, they're also fully adjustable. Again, I believe they're working on compressed air. And you can again adjust those for preload rebound, and again you can lock the forks out as well. Brakes, the brakes are by Logan, hydraulic brakes back and front, and they give you a superb feel. I gotta say, all round the bike is an impressive bike. There's no two ways about it. It's designed for riders from 5'5" to 6'5". Well, I did hear someone say that he thinks with the saddle drop right down, you could get a rider of 5'3" on this bike.
Hiya.
This bike isn't always about going fast. Yeah, you can set it into one of the high power assist modes and ride it really, really quick if you want. As I say, it is a 750 watt motor which has been locked down to 250 watts. But I'm going up a hill here along the Kingsdown Lane. This is a route I often cycle, and I'm just cruising in power assist level 3. Basically just letting the weight of my feet turn the pedals, and it's a bike that you can also just cruise on and just have fun and enjoy the scenery. It's also got a torque sensor, so what that means is that the more you push, the more the bike gives. So here I'm cruising along nice and steady now, pedaling nice and gentle, and I'll give it a bit of oomph, and you'll see how it picks up. This is the last test of the bike now, really. I've come to the 600 foot climb. It's a very steep ascent all the way up to the top of what's known as Uffington Castle, the Iron Age Hill Fort, also known as White Horse Hill. So I'm going to stick the bike in highest assist and pedal up here and see how well we get on with it. I'm in level 5 assistance at the moment, and I'm in a very low gear, but I'm hardly putting any pressure on the pedals at all to go up this ascent. Normally on my normal human powered bike, I would be crawling along about 3 miles an hour. I'm currently doing about 10 miles an hour and not putting in much effort. Oh, a little bit mildly out of breath, but not much. Quite an easy climb. It's not over yet. absolutely flying up this hill, flipping amazing. Anyway, I'm at the up into north now. Right on the highest point almost of the hill. Yeah, it's north. My conclusion on the bike genuinely put a smile on me, to be honest with you, especially some of the technical sort of climbs and bumpy tracks and what have you. It's a very, very plus ride. I really enjoyed the bike. It's got loads of power. It's a shame the UK's restricted it to 16 miles an hour or 15 and a half miles an hour, but that can be done away with if you want to do that. The only one slight downside for me is the height of the seat post. It's only got literally another 2 inches, and then that's it. You can see it's quite short. So I think for me personally, it needs a longer seat post, which I'm sure you can obtain. It probably could do with, for me, it could do with another inch and a half, maybe, to get the optimum seat to pedal height. And I'm 5'10", quite long in the leg. So I think anyone over 6 foot, definitely going to have to get a longer seat post. But apart from that, I really loved it. It's a fantastic bike. If anyone's interested in finding out more about this bike, then there's links in the description to Cyrusher's site, and possibly a discount code there as well. As I say, I was given this bike for free, but I have given an honest review of it. The bike hasn't failed. It's lived up to expectations and exceeded them, and it's a really good bike, really good fun bike. I've enjoyed it. I wouldn't say for me personally it would replace my human pedal powered bikes, because I like them for the long overnight long haul journeys that I do, but for the blast and getting out and about, and for anyone with, well, if anyone wants an easy bike to ride, an e-bike's the way. Or if you've got health compromise or health issues, there's no reason why a person with quite severe health issues could do what I've just done on this bike. It's that good. Anyway, thanks to Cyrusher for sending it to me. Thanks for you for watching the video. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.